Very much for coming to the latest in our webinar series. This one on Nintex and 5 long-term benefits of workflow automation. My name is Tim Noka. I'm just going to introduce a couple of how we're going to work things here today. And then in a moment or two, I will introduce the smart person in the room, the Nintex expert, Laura Hall. Today, as I said, is the latest in our webinar series. You can see more of that in the resource part of our website. The 2020 webinars are yet to be planned, but we are working on getting those scheduled. If you have any questions during today's webinar, we want to be available for those. If you could put them into the question area of the webinar. The webinar software is in the upper right part of your screen. It's possible it's already gotten tucked in. If that's the case, you can see in a real thin strip there, an arrow pointing in towards the screen. If you would hit that, you would see one of the sections there would be for questions. You would pose your questions in there at any time that you have them throughout the webinar. What we're going to do is Laura's going to go through her presentation. We're going to end up at about 30 minutes after the hour, give or take, and then she and I will stay to make sure that all the questions are answered before we leave. So as you put your questions in there, I will verbalize them to her afterwards, and we will make sure that they're answered 100% of them before we leave. Laura Hall has been teaching for over 20 years. The last 10 have been in and around this subject area, and she can confidently say she saved millions of human working hours through working with Nintex and workflow automation annually in those past 10 years. It's pretty impressive. Some of her students have said, Laura knows this stuff inside and out. Her knowledge and explanations of the subject matter is absolutely fantastic. And the last quote that I'll give you says, I would definitely recommend this training for anyone interested in solving business problems using the Nintex application. So again, our thanks that you've come. Our thanks to Laura for her expertise in offering it for the next half hour or so. Laura, the mic is all yours. Thank you.
Great. Thank you, Tim. And hello and good morning, everybody, or good afternoon, depending upon the time zone you're in. I'm going to go ahead and transition to the next slide. So like Tim said, my name is Laura Hall. I've been teaching for over 20 years across 10 different countries. I have been teaching and administering SharePoint and Nintex for over the past 10 years. So my expertise is not just limited to Nintex workflows. I have a much far expansive list. Some of my former clients include the U.S. government and the U.S. Department of Defense, the military side of things. I've also taught some ADA compliancy stuff for the Food and Drug Administration. I'm a published author and have taught for Auburn University. And you can see a couple of other clients listed there as well. Enough about me, though. Let's get into the 5 long-term benefits of Nintex workflow automation. Right. So before I begin and get into these 5 benefits, I just want to let you know that Nintex is designed to work on top of and integrate heavily with your SharePoint environment, whether that is in the cloud or if that's a foundation or if it's a server installation. The first benefit that we get with Nintex workflows is a reduction in human error. Right. Anytime we automate something, we are creating a consistency in results. Things that are done manually by humans tend to have inconsistencies in the quality of work performed, the timeliness of the end result that is delivered, and of course, the reduction of errors. All of this can be automated if it can be done consistently every time by the same group of people, if we know the process and the sequence of steps that need to be performed and all of the players involved in that process, we can automate it. By doing so, we will reduce and eliminate all human errors. The only human errors that would remain would be that has been designed into the automation itself, which of course we'll talk about when we discuss the testing and development of our workflows. So first long-term benefit, the reduction in human error. The second is less risk. By introducing automation through Nintex, we are eliminating the potential risk that the human will simply not perform the action. I don't know about you, but I have dealt with clients and I myself have had a number of people who don't do things on a timely manner. And unfortunately, a lot of the work I do tends to deal with government and national security and intellectual property. So when something needs to get done within an expectation, say, if I need someone to approve a document within 48 hours in order for someone to get paid or for some logistics process to occur, right, in order for the boots on the ground to get the equipment they need in order to provide said national security, in order for that risk to be eliminated or reduced, I need that work to be processed timely. In order to ensure that gets timely and that we have proper accountability, I simply will implement the necessary automation steps for that process being done manually, typically through email and chat. We would then automate it leveraging our SharePoint environment, thus reducing the potential risk that the end result, the business process, or the actual deliverable gets delivered on time or hopefully ahead of time. And this is the big one. This is the one I really like to kind of toot my own horn on and really kind of showcase Nintex's flexibility, because time savings cannot be understated. I have gone into an environment so many times and have found that a process that's currently taking 2 to 6 months realistically should take less than 5 business days. And in some cases, we've even gone from a 6-month timeline down to a 48-hour timeline or a 2 business day timeline. By implementing easy-to-use tools for every level of your team or every level of your business, knowing that most of your team members and coworkers are not technical individuals, nor do they understand the nuances of even leveraging SharePoint, much less knowing how to go in and customize what they need to deliver to you by ensuring that documents get structured correctly, that things get routed to the right people, that the right data goes to the right SharePoint list or in the right site collection, etc. We can eliminate all of that confusion, all of that lack of education, all of that ineptitude by simply implementing the automation. And by our estimates, we have been able to achieve in every single implementation, whether it simply be through the execution of training or it be the actual execution of an on-site workflow that we would help develop, in every single time we have been able to calculate an estimated 80%+ in time savings. Now, I don't know about you guys, but I hate doing things that are mundane. I can't stand doing the same thing repetition over and over again, knowing that the computer can do it faster and more efficient than I can. And I definitely don't want to have teams of people executing the exact same sequence of steps when we're paying them X number of dollars an hour. In the federal government, they pay people quite a bit of money. Sometimes they pay them upwards of $40 an hour to simply do manual data entry. So I love the time-saving aspect of it. And like I said, every single time we've gone into an environment, whether it be through training or it be through some type of consultation work, we almost always can prove a minimum of 80% an increase in time savings in what we call person hours, to be a bit more, you know, politically correct in these present times the way they are. All right, so fewer errors, we're going to reduce the risk of people doing the wrong thing at the wrong time or in the wrong place. We're going to reduce the risk that our deliverables aren't delivered on time. And we're going to definitely save a ton of time and free up ourselves or our other fellow administrators or just our managers and other team members, our coworkers, from being able to go and do tasks that can't be done repetitively. Our fourth long-term benefit is an increase in productivity. What we find, and studies have proven this, that when you free the human mind up from repetitive mundane tasks, you allow their mind to be capable and more flexible in conquering complex business problems. By conquering these complex business problems that we have let sit along the wayside, that we've simply believed was too complex or too difficult to conquer at the moment, we never allow ourselves to truly flex and deliver for our clients what is expected of us and iteratively update those products that we're currently delivering. So by reducing the human errors, reducing the risk of delivering things on time, and by dramatically reclaiming our time, we can increase our productivity first and foremost because we're delivering things a lot faster than we would have prior to this implementation. But also because now we have the time that we need to dedicate to other things we can deliver. And our fifth and final long-term benefit, and I have another slide I want to go into detail about some technical specifics, so please stay with me for that. I just want to get to this really quick, and then we can go in. And this should really, the next slide should really allow you all to flex your technical muscles and really provide some very targeted and specific questions on how Nintex might be capable of providing those particular features for you. But our fifth and final long-term benefit is it's easily scalable. I kind of hinted at this at the beginning of the webinar where I talked about regardless of the implementation you have of SharePoint, whether that's SharePoint Foundation, whether that's SharePoint Server, something you actually have a full data, you actually have a data center and servers and racks, et cetera, or if you're working inside of SharePoint Online, inside of the Office 365 cloud, we can go from one to the other and we can scale exponentially regardless of how large or small your business or organization is. One of the agencies we work for inside of the DoD happens to be the third largest. They are very big and they operate on a global scale across multiple networks, and everything they've done in there can still continue to scale with little to no cost incurred. So to summarize, we're going to reduce the capability of humans to make errors by giving them a structured, repetitive environment that allows the computer to do the work. By accomplishing that, we are going to reduce the time or the potential risk of not delivering the actual result that is asked of us. We are reclaiming personnel's time to allow them to do other tasks that may not be, by their very nature, repetitive or mundane or more complex. We're increasing productivity because now we can do more with less people, we can do more by the reclaim time, et cetera, and we can scale. We can even scale from a foundation or a server implementation all the way into the cloud if there's some type of migration action occurring. If you have any questions about any of these long-term benefits, please, again, post them into the questions area of the webinar, and Tim will field them and translate them for me, okay? At this point in time, I'm gonna go ahead and transition into the next slide. And because it was my understanding that all of you here are technical individuals, I wanted to hit on some of the largest technical capabilities that Nintex provides for us as administrators or as developers with regards to automating our workflow processes. The first one is simply the fact that it's so intuitive. I don't need to learn how to code. I don't need to learn an entirely different language in order to automate any of our workflows. The Nintex software and application for workflows is a simple drag and drop design. It's just like taking an icon from one area of a screen to another and then simply going in and configuring the settings for it. So the drag and drop visual design tools make this a visually easy solution to leverage, and we can automate even some of the most sophisticated processes. In our courses, we have some simple labs we go through and scenarios that are designed to take the concepts that are being presented to you in a very time-crunched way, which is the case for most courses you've ever been to, and allow you to translate that into something that you can then say, I know how to leverage that particular workflow action. Now I can then build on top of that knowledge and put all the pieces together. What we find, and this is the big selling point with Nintex workflow automation, is that I don't need to spend months or years potentially learning how to code before I ever can begin creating an automation solution that's even available for user testing inside of a development environment. I can take you from no knowledge, along with ProTech, we can take you from no knowledge within 4 days to being able to conquer some of the most complex problems that you may have once thought were incapable of being automated. So instead of going from months to years, we limit that down to days. The second capability I want to highlight here is how it's integrated. This is designed to work as a site feature, for those of you who are aware of what that is. It's an add-on that integrates inside of SharePoint. It gets enabled as a site feature, and it allows us to touch and manipulate any information that is connected to our SharePoint environment. Now, I have another bullet here. I want to go into some of those specifics. But if the information can see or talk to logically to your SharePoint environment, we can leverage workflows to automate the recording, the copying, the manipulation, the deletion, the collaboration of efforts. And we can do this across all of your business channels. This isn't just limited to your administrators or just to users. This could even be integrated with internal employees and external clients. And I see the chat button flashing, so I know Tim is going to field some questions for me when I get to the end of this. So the third technical capability I really wanted to highlight here really kind of goes into that long-term benefit of scalability. Because we can connect and manipulate data across every application and platform that connects to our SharePoint environment, these can include, and by the way, there's some pretty powerful data repositories. I can access SQL, Oracle. I can do custom API calls to web servers, even if the web server isn't ours to control. I just need login credentials to get to it. We can integrate with Active Directory in the form of LDAP queries, and we can also integrate inside of all of your Office 365 applications. Teams is a really big one, collaborative platform of Office 365 Teams. We can integrate directly with that particular application and automate anything you want inside of there. And while I don't have the time necessary in order to outline every single enterprise application that SharePoint can connect to, rest assured, if SharePoint can connect and can see it, Nintex automated workflows can also accomplish the tools and the results that you need to automate your business processes. Now, a lot of questions I get regarding Nintex workflow automation seems to be one of the options that people think are not capable of performing. They don't really understand content types inside of SharePoint, and they definitely don't understand how to automate the creation of complex, stylized documents. And that's actually the one here I wanted to highlight next. We can generate very precise documents. Whether or not you leverage a content type or not is really irrelevant, although it does make the process of creation the document very easy. But we can input and insert or read and extract information from any document, regardless of how stylized it is. These document formats include things like Word, Excel, PowerPoint, PDF documents. I can translate and convert documents from one format to another. I can then send them across any of the different applications and platforms that we're integrated with. What I tend to find more often than not is people need signatures from members of a bureaucratic authority. They need leadership to sign off on something. And usually there's 2, 3, 4, 5 different layers of approvals that are required. And sometimes layer 1 will approve it, layer 2 will approve it, layer 3 doesn't, and it has to go back. And because of this complex interconnectivity between the 3 different layers or the 5 different layers or the 15 different layers, needing to go back and forth until finally everyone agrees on the actual outcome and everyone signs it, we find that people believe that that particular problem can't be automated. And I rest assure you, it can. There's this really, really cool tool inside of workflows called state machines. And I would love to be able to teach it to you. You can go and look at some of the information on the Nintex community forums, but I promise you the actual in-person instruction for that is really, really interesting. It's one of my favorite segments of content regarding this. And a lot of times it's really funneled around the document creation or approval processes, or maybe we're approving a particular publication to our website in the form of marketing material or in the form of a credit card offer to a group of clients, etc. So I want to go ahead and wrap up this slide here, and then we'll begin to field questions in a couple of minutes. And I can go back and touch on any of these points again through the questions, etc. If you can leverage content types, just to stay here with the documents just for a second, if you can leverage content types or if you can learn about content types, and honestly, what we found with our Nintex workflows training is that more often than not, I and ProTech, we end up teaching SharePoint along with Nintex workflows. So what we recommend actually is that you get courses and you chain them together so that you can build upon the knowledge as you go along. So we highly recommend that there's SharePoint training that comes as a precursor or a prerequisite to the Nintex stuff, because in order to navigate and leverage Nintex workflows, you really need to be a competent individual and user with regards to navigating and leveraging the technology of SharePoint. The language is really, really important when we get to that point. Last but not least of the technical capabilities I want to discuss here is the empowerment. I can't tell you how many times I have gone into an environment and have found 2 systems administrators that are the only admins for 18,000 plus employees. As an administrator, we have a lot of things on our plate. The last thing that we have time to do is develop new solutions for problems that aren't our own. Well, going back to the intuitiveness of this software and this tool, allowing the drag and drop and the learning curve being a lot less steep than that of other custom coding solutions, this tool allows us to, with very little effort and very little time investment, to provide the necessary empowerment to developers and power users and those content managers, people that are managing the lists and managing the libraries and managing your project management sections inside of SharePoint, with the necessary knowledge and tools to automate their own respective challenges in their business processes. Now, they can leverage your existing documentation with regards to how they operate inside of your environment, of course, as they would with any developer, any power user, any content manager, where they're required to align with the particular guidelines and rules that they need to operate within. But the last thing you want to do is be the sole source of their solution. So the empowerment of this really goes back to the intuitiveness of how little effort it takes and how little time it takes to actually get someone from no knowledge to being effectively capable of creating workflows that automate our particular business processes in a very short amount of time. So the empowerment piece for me is always the biggest one. And when I find someone who's never done SharePoint administration, who's getting brought into the developer or the content manager or the power user roles inside of SharePoint, what really I find, that's where the biggest wins are, because these are the people that haven't yet been beaten down by years and years and years of administration. These are the people who are still hungry for change. These are the people who have the time and the subject matter expertise with regards to that particular area of the organization. They're the ones that know how to do that process inside and out, and how to adapt and how to structure when things don't necessarily go according to plan. So this will conclude the technical capability segment of our webinar. And at this point in time, I'd like to go ahead and begin fielding questions from Tim. I know you're going to read out from chat with us. If you have any questions regarding the long-term benefits or any of the technical capabilities here, even if the question is, well, how would Nintex workflows allow me to accomplish that? Give me something specific. Laura, talk about the actual workflow control I would need. I'd be happy to answer any and all of those questions.
I appreciate that, Laura, and I do have two questions. One of them is kind of close to what you just said there, and it's focusing in on the document part that you spoke about. I wonder if you could give us another level deeper. It's interesting that you said you could automate sort of, you know, the back and forth that it takes to get, you know, 2, 3, 15 signatures. And we have a question if you could, you know, go a little more technically deeper on how that can be. You know, obviously you can't sign somebody's name. So,
of course. So here, let me give you a very relevant example of something I deal with almost every single month. A lot of my clients even deal with these every single week. When we need to have an invoice signed off, or if I need to have a document signed off by a supervisor to allow me to take time off, or if I'm going to take time off in the long term, if I need to take, say, more than 30 days off because I'm going in for surgery, right? I probably have to submit a different form of process than simply sending an email to my boss saying, hey, I'm going to take next Friday off. We're going to have a 3-day weekend and I'm going to go to, you know, Atlanta for the weekend, whatever the case is. The invoice is the one I really like to leverage because we can build upon another Nintex tool called Nintex Forms, where we can leverage a specific form control called a repeating section. But let me talk about the document and why it's important. With regards to precise document creation, an invoice, something that you would submit to your client to ask them to pay for product or services rendered, or if you are the person who have provided said product or service and you're asking to get paid from the work that you have accomplished, well, that document is going to look dramatically different than if I was simply asking someone to approve an award document for someone in our team to get an award from the director of operations for a particular division. And if I'm dealing with a legal contract for a new employee who's getting onboarded, well, that contract is going to look dramatically different, both in style and in content and structure, and more and probably in length, than an invoice would, or a request for time off is going to look. all of these documents, their structure, their content, their styling with regards to, say, heading one versus heading two, what type of font am I using, where is it being ruled on the page, can I integrate dynamic information existing inside of SharePoint? All of that can get input from SharePoint or other sources. Again, SQL, Oracle Web Servers, Active Directory. I can put all of that information, if I can see it, if I can read it, I can inject it into a document that meets all of the existing requirements for that particular type of document, like an invoice or a new employee contract, or maybe we're hiring a vendor to come in and have them install some new piece of, like maybe we need them to install an ice machine in our break room because the other one broke. It's been there for 15 years. It finally broke. We hired a new vendor. Now we need to actually give them, the authorization to come into the facility. Those documents are going to look dramatically different from one another depending upon the scope of work being performed. And we may need to ask for different people across the organization, whether that organization exists just in Atlanta, or whether we work in all of the Southeast, or whether we work at the global scale. I'm still going to need at some point someone to approve the payment of said thing, or the approval of time off, or the approval of this work getting designated out to a particular team. The reason why I mentioned content types inside of SharePoint and leveraging that with Nintex automated workflow document creation is because that stylized foundation of the document, you know, the logos, the heading, the footers, where things are, the different fonts we have available, the different custom stylized sets that have been integrated inside of the Microsoft Word document as an example. You can create a template for that document, including the insertion of information specific as to where that might go. Maybe it goes in paragraph 2 in sentence number 3. That's where the actual employee's name goes. Maybe we put their social in paragraph 5. Maybe we don't even put it on the first page. Maybe it's on the fifth page, buried in some type of legal jargon. Or even better yet, maybe when we do a new employee contract, depending upon the employee type, whether they're an intern, whether they're going to be a full-time employee, whether they're going to be an executive, there might be different information that gets injected into the document. But at the very least, we're still going to have the company logo. We're still going to need to put the date in which the document got created. Maybe there's an expiration with regards to their employment. Right? Maybe they're only going to be an intern with us for the next 3 months. So we want to make sure that information is both captured in SharePoint and then generated in a document as well. And of course, all of this can be read from a document that gets imported in, even if the document source didn't originate inside of SharePoint. Right? We can still leverage Nintex workflow automation to go in and read that information and then distribute it amongst all of the different people that might be involved. A new employee coming in, you have a lot of different teams that are involved that need to do their job both effectively and timely before that employee can come in on day one and even be given access to the facility or even access to the network, right? We got to get an employee contract signed. We've probably got to establish their banking information for payroll, legal and HR. There's probably some onboarding training has to be accomplished. They may or may not have to go through a formalized security process where they get their badge. They might have to go and get a picture taken, a background check. All of this stuff is still a requirement at the end of the day. And a lot of times what we find is that it takes a very long time with inconsistent results, hence the need for automation. So for the person who asked the question, I'm not sure who it was, but does that satisfy the question, or would you like me to go into greater detail of content types and the specific documents themselves?
I will invite the person to go ahead and write again into the question area if you want. I've got one more question for you, Laura. Could you give us a sense, Laura, of how many people are using Nintex Workflow in their businesses right now?
Nintex Workflow, if you actually go to Nintex's website, they have specific statistics that they're tracking as of, I think it was the end of quarter 3 in 2018, where they had in the 20 or 80 million range of users actually leveraging this. What I find in my personal experience is that anything regarding new IT software, and this doesn't even necessarily have to equate to only Nintex or only Nintex Workflows or only SharePoint, but what I find is that generally, human beings, we fear that which we don't understand, or more aptly, we fear that which we haven't been trained on. Our jobs are so driven upon our results that we know consistently how to achieve the results the way we've always been doing it for the last 5, 10, 15, 20 years, depending upon how long you've been doing that job or how long you've been working in the industry, that without proper training, we simply don't know what we don't know. We don't know how to take something that's been taking me 2+ months to achieve with regards to getting people's approvals and onboarding this new employee, et cetera, right? Getting them on the network and all of that. I don't know how to leverage SharePoint and how to leverage Nintex workflows to make that process go from 2 months down to, say, 3 days. With more training comes user adoption. And that has really been the biggest key and one of the cruxes that we find across the IT training industry. This isn't just with SharePoint or with Nintex workflows. Users don't use things they don't understand. Plain and simple, right? And this also goes with tools that you create inside of your own environment. If you create an automated workflow that does work for somebody and they don't know what that's doing, there's a good chance that they won't leverage it. So I know that there's some very big names in the industry who leverage Nintex workflows. They're listed on the Nintex site. I don't want to try and quote them from memory, but we're talking millions and millions of users using this every single day. And more are beginning to jump on board because more people are getting training, more people are being exposed to the capabilities, and administrators and technical representatives like yourselves here in attendance today are finding out how easy it is to take something that we once thought was incapable of being automated in a matter of days and having it completely up and running in production after a minimal amount of training and a minimal amount of development and a little bit of time in testing. I don't like to put things in production without testing them myself. We're talking from training to deployment of a complex problem. We're talking less than 2.5 weeks. That's a really low time from I know nothing about what I'm doing to being able to tackle the most difficult problem in my company or in my organization or just even inside of my team. Not a whole lot of software tools can make that claim. And that is why I really kind of want to tout the horn of Nintex. They've done a really good job of making this tool easy to use, drag and drop. You don't need to know how to code. You don't even really know how to program. All you simply need to know is you need to know the language of Nintex. You need to know how to use the tool, all of which is provided in the training. And then you need to know the business process inside and out, or you need to know people that know the business process. You can't automate something that you don't know how to do it. If you know how to do it and you know the knowledge of Nintex, you can take the culmination of both of those things and you can accomplish some really large feats.
Okay, very good. And with that in mind, I'm out of questions. So with that in mind, I'd like to just go ahead and point us towards some of our education and training without getting too much in detail, just a brief commercial. We are currently in the process of planning our 2020 education dates, but certainly off of our website, plugging in the phrase Nintex gets you access to all of the Nintex courses that are available. 1 to 4 day classes, very often paired up with SharePoint, as Laura spoke about a couple of times in the webinar, makes a lot of sense as well. So with that, Laura, any other closing comment?
No, I just wanted to highlight here some of the contact information on ProTech and how you can acquire training. They have an email address here, info@protechtraining.com. Or if you're like me and you prefer talking on the phone versus email, I don't know the age group here. Some of you might be millennials. Some of you may prefer email itself. But their phone number is 800-373-9188. Again, that's 1-800-373-9188. Or you can email them at info@protechtraining.com. They have a website as well. Most of us do. www.protechtraining.com. And you can register for upcoming webinars. You can review past webinars and their recordings. And you can locate some articles and some of our product lineups, as well as inquire about how to how to ascertain the specific training you need to be able to take advantage of some of the amazing tools out there for you to save you a lot of time and a lot of money.
Excellent. Thank you very much, Laura. And thank you all for coming. Appreciate your time today. Hope you have a good rest of the day and a great holiday season. And thank you also, Laura, for your expertise today.
You're very welcome. Thank you, everyone, for attending. I really appreciate it, and I appreciate the questions.
All right. Take care now.